Today I'll be talking about least privilege and separation of duties for AWS ACM Private CA, which is a service that allows you to create and manage certificate authorities. Let's talk about why least privilege and separation of duties is important. Least privilege is the concept of only giving users access to what they need to do their job. Separation of duties is the concept that users should not have all the privileges necessary to complete a critical business activity on their own. The concept of implementing quorum means that no single user can complete the entire certificate authority setup on their own, and that three distinct personas, a quorum of three, are required to create an operational CA. Today we'll be using three personas to illustrate these concepts. The first persona is the certificate authority administrator, who is responsible for creating, configuring, and managing certificate authorities. They require many permissions to set attributes about the certificate authority, as well as physically creating the certificate authority using AWS API calls. This user will also be managing the permissions and policies of that certificate authority. This user also requires permissions to Amazon S3, AWS Resource Access Manager, and the permissions necessary to list and describe certificates and certificate authorities. The second persona is the certificate signer and issuer. This user is managing certificate signing requests as well as certificate issuance. The certificate importer is the last role and is responsible for importing the CA signed certificate into the CA, which will make it fully operational. Let's take a closer look at the permissions required for each role. Here's an example of what the IAM policy document looks like that is used with the certificate authority administrator role. Let's look at the certificate signer and issuer IAM policy. Lastly, let's look at the certificate importer IAM policy. The first step to create a certificate authority is using the create certificate authority command, which is run by the certificate authority administrator. Next, the certificate signer and issuer role will use the get certificate authority CSR command to retrieve a CSR from the certificate authority, which is delivered as a PEM file. Next, the issue certificate command is used, which requires the previously retrieved CSR file. This command sends the CSR file to the certificate authority for signing, which is then returned as a certificate ARN. Below, there's an example of what an ARN looks like. The certificate ARN is used to retrieve the certificate from the certificate authority by the signer and issuer role. This certificate comes down in a PEM format. Last, the import certificate authority certificate command is run by the certificate importer role. This imports the CA signed certificate into the CA using the import certificate authority certificate API call. To further enhance least privilege in this scenario, I would recommend using service control policies to explicitly deny actions at the AWS account level. Furthermore, implementing conditional logic to restrict access to specific resources is a great next step, so that only certain commands can be run on certain certificate authorities. Lastly, it's important to configure event-based controls to detect and monitor API activity. Thanks for joining me as we explored least privilege and separation of duties for AWS ACM PCA. Next, I'll be doing a technical demo of this solution, and I'd recommend you check out other ACM videos done by my colleagues on creating a certificate authority, CA hierarchies, disaster recovery, sharing private CAs, and using certificate templates. Thanks so much for your time.